As you can tell, this is strictly going to be an audio review only, because I can conduct myself better, as remembering my lines on camera is something I really struggle with. That said, on with the review. The casting of this flick was just amazing, as everyone turned in a great performance. Michael Keaton is just a treat to watch. But that's not exactly something we didn't know already. At the beginning of the movie, you feel sympathy for him as Ray Kroc, not being able to get the successful payoff he's looking for as a milkshake mixer salesman, try saying that four times fast, and the trials and tribulation he goes through trying in vain to sell his mixers. It's only when he comes across a large order placed by the McDonald's restaurant from San Bernardino, California, hope I pronounced that correctly, that he goes to see for himself with the high volume of customers as their clientele and how speedy the service compared to waiting for 30 minutes and not 30 seconds like most fast food outlets would have been at the time. But then there's the other side of the movie where you grow to dislike him as he becomes a bit of a weasel, where he starts passing himself off as the creator of McDonald's and its speedy service, and making business decisions and suggestions that go beyond the boundaries of the contract that Mac and Richard McDonald had laid out for him. I understand the point of view that you have to think outside of the box and try ideas that will save money and upscale the profits without compromising on the quality of the product, but it's just how he went about doing that I, and probably the rest of the audience, had a problem with. Also, and I have to bring this up, he has to go and do a real classless act by opening his new restaurant at the end of the flick opposite the brothers' first restaurant, of which they are no longer to bear the name McDonald's. I appreciate business is business, but that's just nasty. Oh, and it doesn't stop there. He sees the wife of a restaurant owner in Joan Smith, played by Linda Cardellini, which, when you get to the end of the movie set in 1970, you see her by Ray's side as his wife. So, he's not only a weasel businessman, but he's also a wife stealer. But it's Michael Keaton doing it with a charm that comes so naturally to him. And because he's Batman. John Carroll Lynch, who plays Maurice Mac McDonald, comes across as being a really open and friendly character, and for the most part, he listens to Ray's suggestions before he starts overstepping the mark, going against the core principles of his and his brother's business. One situation that gets him so wound up that he has a diabetic shock that lands him in hospital. But that said, if someone has started a corporation that bears the name of your business with your logo of the golden arches that isn't theirs to begin with, I think you'd be inclined to be a little miffed as well. Nick Offerman, who occupies the role of Richard McDonald, is a real hard-nosed businessman that stays firmly to the way he likes the operation to be run and takes huge exception to how Ray makes changes to the franchise and how the business is run. Considering when he suggests to switch ice cream to powder for the milkshakes, as he maintained milkshakes should be made of milk and not from instant powder. I mentioned that Laura Dern was amazing for what she did in the spoiler-free review, but via the same token, she wasn't used enough, and that is such a waste for a high-caliber talent like herself. You really get the sense of neglect and frustration from her as Ethel Kroc with the way Ray is away, see what I did there, so often, and not understanding his desire for more success and wealth when they already have a reasonable, comfortable living. You feel for her when Ray asks for a divorce out of the blue in such a non-sensitive manner at the dinner table. But you could argue, as you see throughout the movie, that it was coming through how distant they are at night and in conversation, where Ray is more interested in becoming a fast food tycoon and not devoting enough time to her. I loved the cinematography and the lighting that really helped capture the look of a bygone era with era-authentic logos from the 50s of McDonald's and Coca-Cola. Same thing with the score Carter Burwell produced that really captures the 50s sound, along with Michael and Linda duetting with Pennies from Heaven on the piano. Who knew that Batman could sing? I went into this movie intrigued and came up feeling in awe of knowing this is how McDonald's came to be from the 1950s onwards. The founder gets a AAA+ must. Until next time, folks, this is MJ Knight signing off from Real Features.